Go.
Oh, damn it.
No.
Wait.
Can you
get
that?
Oh, yeah, I can do that.
What? I can do that as well.
So the final show is done, and now the van's all packed up, and the van people are leaving. Come along, Jason.
And as the van slowly pulled away, very slowly, we all thought to ourselves, this was it. This was the end of our trip. What to do next, none of us really knew. Maybe it was going to be the pub, maybe a show.
But maybe the van, some of us could just go home.
But the van was coming towards us, we thought, fuck me, we should probably get out the way.
The van slowly and inexorably ran over Hannah.
The funeral was away arranged for the next Wednesday. None of us could make it. We were on holiday.
Bye-bye. Drive safe.
Goodbye, my lover.
The rest of you.
Goodbye, my friend.
See you again.
Sally, I'm taking with your baby.
As I'm not going to miss you that.
Here we go. Oh, you're just waiting.
They didn't let us.
They didn't let us see us. That's so rude.
No, they're focused on it. And now to the pub.
To the pub!
The show may have finished, but the Edinburgh adventure is still far from over. We've gone off to the Three Sisters for a well-earned drink or two, and I discovered that I have forgotten the bag that has all of my dad's stuff in it. It's rather embarrassing, but I can't go back in there to get it at the moment because I've just been told that there's a show in there and it doesn't come out till 20 to 11, so I'm heading back to the Three Sisters now to wait. Hopefully I won't forget it again. But, you know, in the interim we have had a partial game of Sopia, and Jason and I have met a very, very nice French comic book artist called Lucy. Can't complain. Okay. I got the bag back. Thank fuck for that. Otherwise, this could have been an extremely embarrassing trip. Right. Now to get back to the pub.
Ladies and gentlemen of the Signet Company, this is your 5-hour call. You have 5 hours to get ready to depart.
Ladies and gentlemen of the plane crew, this is your 5-hour call. 5 hours till you have to leave for the airport. Thank you.
Jason, I feel you should explain why you have a platypus on your shoulder.
Because.
Thank you.
Okay, everyone else is in bed and I'm just about to catch what little sleep I can. I'm just thinking, there'll probably be a bit of footage tomorrow to film, but I wanted to make the point now that we've been up here for 13 days. It's the culmination of months of work. We decided that we wanted to do this way back at the beginning of this year. And here we are at the end of it. We bloody did it. Yeah. this is a testament to, you know, what a group of small, like-minded, determined people can do if they are dedicated to a cause. And I think we've done ourselves proud. This has been an absolutely fantastic experience, and I sincerely hope this is not the last time I myself personally am at the Fringe. And I think the others feel the same way too. Each one of us has been indispensable, and it is through our diligence and our belief in this project that we have managed to pull it off. I think, not to toot our own horn too much, but we've done ourselves proud here. This is going to be an invaluable experience that we will carry with us for the rest of our lives. And that's a nice feeling.
Day 13. I get to have a lion! Which is somewhat negated by the fact that I woke up specifically just to deliver this video report. Pause.
I hate you sometimes, Jason. We're going home. Guys, summary thoughts for the trip? Yeah? You did eat rather a lot just recently. It's actually awkward, huh? Okay. Tessa. Okay. I caught his reaction. Come again. Just went for the bags. It's been a funny old trip.